clear skies over Petco Park in San Diego. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series.
Hey, everybody. How y'all doing? It's I, Super Paul Games, and welcome back to the Tug Dick Show. I keep wanting to think we're on the Padres because of when I was streaming baseball earlier in the year on Twitch. We are number one in the National League West. We are half a game up on whoever's next. Tug Dick in the number three spot. You know who in the number four spot.
And then briefly, let's take a look at the two starting pitchers.
Santa?
The assignment here.
I meant for their pitcher. Hilarious commentary by me, meh. Let's do it. Let's play some baseball.
Tug Dick.
Tug Dick in the middle of an eight-game hitting streak, hitting 316 during it.
Which stands at eight games coming in.
You see Brandon Moss on deck over there. He's checking out Tug Dick's ass. Top of the first, two outs.
Swinging a high bouncer to short.
I don't know if that's going to hop enough. Oh. Son of a butt. I thought we were going to run that out. It was going slow. The shortstop had a good throw there. I thought we had a real chance to run that out. Frustration! Oh, well. Top of the first done. Let's move into the second.
So runners at the corners with two gone.
Uh-oh. Like they said, runners at the corners. Bottom of the first, two outs. If we don't catch this, they're going to get a run in. Hopefully it's an easy pop fly for the Dick Meister. Mr. Dickalicious. Yep. You have been dick robbed. No run for you, San Diego Padres. It looks like a beautiful pretend day in the game. Like, if I could jump into the game, I'd be like, ah, get me a hot dog and a beer.
Steven Houston strides into the box now to lead off the
whole. You ain't no Sam Houston. Ah, history jokes. We're down by a run, bottom of the second. Our Giants are not doing very well thus far. I mean, I know it's really early in the game yet.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And Mark
oh.
will stay with this one for the first out.
Almost made up with Bluto unintentionally.
What a nice job at third of knowing exactly where he is in relation to his surroundings. And he's able to make the play on the move to record that out.
Tug Dick is just like, Bluto, I wanted to see you catch it up close and personal. Top of the fourth, their pitcher seems to be like tearing through our lineup. All right, here goes nothing.
And now here's a swing and a ground ball.
All right, we keep that hit streak alive. I was kind of hoping we were going to rock it a little harder than that, but something's better than nothing.
Boy, when you watch this guy, he has had a great approach for these last couple series, and now he's got nine straight games with a base hit.
That's right, nine straight games. Brandon Moss coming up. No outs. We're down by a run. Just get in the damn batter's box, you wiener. You're only going to strike out anyway.
Here comes the pitch to Moss.
That's a good fastball. That's the first step in there. Santa blew him away with his Santa magic.
No runs, two hits, and no errors on the Giant ledger to this point.
Let's see if we can go.
And a pitch out.
I'm glad we did it. Maybe you could tell. They did their scouting report. Tug Dick usually goes on the second pitch. We're going for it.
Pitch is a cold strike. The throw.
Oh, we did not make it. Damn it, a little too aggressive. Aggressive Dick, oh well. Well, something happened. We tied the game. I don't know how. Maybe Brandon Moss got a hit because Dick wasn't on base. Whatever. Runners the first and second, top of the fifth, two outs. This would be the perfect opportunity to go ahead. Oh no, my bat exploded! Safe! You too slow, pitcher. You can't catch up with the Dick. That bat died a hero. Tug Dick had a run the fastest he ever ran before to beat that out.
A chance to compose himself. He's been great so far, so
it worked out. I thought it was going to be something we were going to hit a little harder, but it's hard to when your bat blows up. Brandon Moss coming up, 1-for-2. Yes. See, I think he did get a hit earlier because Tug Dick wasn't on. Base is loaded. Brandon Moss is set up for a big RBI situation.
They get a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. Changes up on him if that's in the dirt for a ball.
Hey, Brandon Moss, you know why Rolling Stone is great? Brandon Moss is like, because of the music? You'd be like, no. Tug Dick would be like, no, because the Rolling Stone guy, there's no Moss. No Moss. We hate you.
He waits. Now the pitch.
Oh, my God. Did you do something good? Go, Brandon Moss. Two RBI single. Well done. Tug Dick is like, that encourages me. Maybe I need to rag on him more.
He was looking for a fastball there. I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right.
No hit my balls.
Brandon Crawford will step in.
Wolverine! Unfortunately, Wolverine is 0-for-2, but that's all right. I like that we're in the lead. Come on, Wolverine. Let's add to this lead. Show San Diego who is boss. Hey, that'd be a great idea for a sitcom.
Come set, now the pitch.
That or The Odd Couple with Tug Dick and Brandon Moss.
3 runs already home here.
This is one of the things I love about baseball, too. It's just, you know, a nice sunny day, a nice relaxed atmosphere, and it's just chill. Oh, Crawford! Once again, stranded on third, the Tug Dick story, but the important thing, Brandon Moss actually got a damn hit to knock some people in. Finally, the number 4 hitter getting some hits.
San Francisco leads this one, 3-1. Jed Jerko.
What a Jerko, that dead Jed Jerko. We're up by a run, runners on the corners, 2 outs, bottom of the 7th. I heard he was Jerkoing it in the bathroom earlier today. I know, that was crude. It was a dick joke. Oh, shit. You got it, Crawford. Tug Dick stole it. Tug Dick is like, nah, Wolverine, this one's mine.
Strand the potential tying run at third. Friars forced to settle for just the one. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now.
Well, 2 innings are left. If we can get 6 more outs and not give up any runs, we win.
Tony Sipp will be summoned from the bullpen now, so he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Sounds much cooler that way when they say summon. Like he's a genie or a demon or something. Tony Sipp, we summon you! Top of the 8th, no outs. Tug Dick, 2-for-2. Still up by only a run, though. Brand new pitcher on the mound.
Now a half swing here as he wanted to pull it back.
Oh,
he
I
so too late.
Oh, I wasn't able to get it back.
Shadows starting to fall over this Southern California.
I was a little too jacked because sometimes
so far
they'll come right at you with the first
really
pitch.
You know, both pitchers, they've been as advertised. It's been a tightly played game and the scoreboard shows it. Now here's the pitch.
Oh,
comes up empty there on a pitch in the dirt and falls behind now 1-2.
That changeup was much lower than I thought. I should have taken on everything. I need a time machine.
Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed. So
twice on the same pitch. Oh well. Tug Dick still 2-for-4 so far today. See, Tug Dick did that purposely. It wasn't a bad at bat. He was trying to help Brandon Moss out. Because you know Brandon Moss gets scared when Tug Dick is on base.
Yonder Alonso will stay.
Where is he? He's over yonder. I know I've said that probably in the last video, but I like it. Bottom of the 8th, no outs. We need 6 outs. Still have a 1-run lead. Oh, no. Damn it, San Diego. Someone pick me up over there. They just tied it up. Coach is like, what is this crap?
Rizzo with a solo home run. And the Padres have come back.
Come on, Padres. Why you gotta make us work so hard? He's like, Coach told me he'd buy me the other half of the shirt if I got a home run.
How's this for a welcome to the ballgame? One pitch and see you later. I've got a feeling that's not what the manager had in mind.
There's Tug Dick trying valiantly to get up there, but he couldn't. Top of the ninth. Holy crap, we opened up a can of whoop-ass. We're going to win this. We're up 7-3. Just getting some insurance runs.
Pitch on the way, and now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swinger from a guy like him. Especially.
I thought we were going to be out for sure. It just like rode up the second baseman. Either he liked to feel the balls rolling up on him, or Tug Dick got a good piece of that.
That's for sure. He has absolutely eaten him up here in this series. Delivers again.
Yeah, Tug Dick's got a 9-game hitting streak going on. Brandon Moss is having a big game too, 2-for-4. Finally, the number 4 hitter waking up. We're going to try and go on the next pitch.
And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
Yeah, he needed that one. Something to give him a little bit of confidence.
I honestly don't care if we run out. I know we maybe shouldn't normally do this, but it's 2 outs. That's a good time to run.
He's running toward second. Pitches a cold strike.
Oh, I thought he was safe. Caught stealing twice. That's all right. Suck it, Moss. Uh-oh. Bottom of the ninth, 2 outs. Men on first and second. This is the first game, I think, all year where Tug Dick got caught stealing twice. He hardly ever gets caught stealing. I guess he's got to go back to stealing school.
Now a swing and he pops him up.
Oh, you got it, Wolverine. Woo! And we win!
The catch to end it for the final out.
Yeah! I was worried for a bit. Oh, Bochy and McDowell, get a room.
Well, maybe a little problem is that they wind up
outfield buddies! Yay! Hunter Pence and Tug Dick and somebody else. Oh yeah, there's the character model with the white head and the black body. I forgot about that. I assume because this has been carried over since, what, 2014? That was a glitch in that year, and it keeps getting carried over that way? I can't imagine that 3 years in a row they hadn't bothered to fix it. Top hitter of the game was Hunter Pence. Oh, it's because he had a home run. So he only had 2 hits. Tug Dick hit better than that. Yeah, you can see Tug Dick supporting him. Actually, Tug Dick just walked by. He's like, I wanted to look cool in my sexy shades. So I thought I'd hit a home run to show him on TV. Hi, Mom, I'm on TV.
He's our top player of the game.
Are you my mom?
He came through with a couple of hits, but more importantly...
Good job by Hunter Pence. Let's go look at the standings. Not bad. Tug Dick had a really good game. Just, it did suck he got caught stealing twice, but still, 3-for-5 is definitely going to help out that average. He's made up a lot of... What would you say? Territory? Space? I'm good at words. I'm a professional announcer. I'm like, I want to go poo, and then I do, and I'm like, it's happening. That was gross. His average is going up to 251. Not super impressive, but considering how he started out, that's cool. We are a game and a half up on the Dodgers, 2 games up on the Diamondbacks, 2 on the Rockies, and 4.5 on the Padres. It wasn't that long ago when we were, what, dead last? We're going to skip training, and let's go play the Cubbies. Apparently, Tug Dick is going to come in to pinch hit. We are down by a run in the ninth. Please tell me there's no outs. And apparently there's a man on first. Richie Gorriel will be pitching. He's got a really good ERA, unfortunately. I'm surprised they didn't put a pinch runner in at first. It looks like Tug Dick would be a better pinch runner. He's only hitting 251. I mean, I don't know who else is on the bench, though, that they had to go to.
Time called here.
So we do get a pinch runner.
Run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little
Gregor Blanco. What's up, Rizzo? How's Gonzo doing? It's like you say that every time. It's good to finally be home.
Breaking ball for a strike.
That's all right. I didn't want the curveball.
Two out with the man at first.
The odds of them giving me a fastball right down the middle on the first pitch were not very likely.
Pitch is a called strike. The throw.
Safe.
It's on the back.
No.
He is out trying to take second, and this ball game is over.
Damn it!
Wow, just a really great game to watch.
I mean, I guess that makes sense. Like Tug Dick did that the other game, but we won. I think we won when Tug Dick did it. We lost when Gregor Blanco did that. Maybe they should have done the other way around, put Tug Dick on base as he's the fastest guy on team, and then let Blanco pinch hit. Oh well. Well, if you're a Cubbies fan, that works out, right? That's where it's frustrating if you're a player. You're like, I sat on the bench all game. I got one pitch. I didn't even get a swing, and then the game was over. Doesn't really matter who the player of the game was. Probably Carlos Robles. Oh, Travis Wood, their pitchers, I guess. They used to have another great pitcher named Wood there long ago. I wonder if Tug Dick comes back to the dugout. Yeah. I wonder if he comes back to the dugout and he's like, Bochy, what the fuck, man? Why'd you send Gregor Blanco on the first pitch? Ooh, we got some magic balls. That's nice. Alright, let's play the Cubbies again. Team ranking by putouts. Brandon Moss is number 3. He should be number 1 because he puts me out the most by his failures. Miguel Cabrera is on the Rangers? Fuck this game. No. That is not where he belongs.
Saturday night baseball here on the show from AT&T Park in San Francisco. Tonight, game 2 of this 3-game series between the Chicago Cubs and the San Francisco Giants.
Let's go Giants! Maybe we can have more than one at-bat.
Take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Chicago Cubs. As their starting 9 tonight will look like this.
Oh no! That means our hit streak is done! Isn't it? Because that one at-bat with one swing? Does that count as a full at-bat?
You see their numbers right there.
It might not. I don't remember how that works. I hope not. I hope that doesn't ruin our hit streak. I would be so pissed if it did. I don't think that counts. Tug Dick leading the team in stolen bases. Man, I'm first one out.
He's ready now, the pitch.
Oh!
A hearty cut there to begin the at-bat.
I hesitated. I should have just gone at it right away. Because I didn't expect such a sweet pitch right away. Oh, not a double play ball.
Poop.
Well, that was pretty quick.
Uh-oh.
Runners on second and third, top of the second, two outs. If he gets a good hit here, they could do stuff that sucks.
Chases one up the ladder.
You got Tug Dick.
In the air to left field.
Boom.
Dick is there and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job.
Yeah, you're welcome. The pitcher should be thanking Tug Dick right now.
A couple of walks, but no damage.
Yeah, tied ball game.
San Francisco.
Going into the bottom of the second. Tug Dick 0 for 1, bottom of the fourth, no outs. Totally tied ball game now. Totally tied ball game, everybody. Like, uh-oh, Tug Dick went to the valley. Sass Valley. I try to go to Ass Valley, but my ass was too small. That's annoying. He still hit it pretty hard if he was jammed. Give me some peanut butter and bread for that jam. Ernest goes to baseball camp. Top of the sixth, no outs. Check that out. Check me out, Thomas the Tank Engine and friend wannabes. Boom.
Is under it to put it away, and it's one pitch, one out to kick off.
Tug Dick, 0 for 2. Okay, so the streak is still alive. He needs a hit, though. We have a one-run lead over the Cubbies. He's not going to get a lot more bats. Maybe one more after this.
Here's the pitch.
Oh! Just a little late. That was our pitch, too. Fastball right down the middle.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
One thing we've seen from this guy on the
mound, we just needed to get a little more on top of that. I was hoping it was going to go deep to the right field.
Out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second.
No. You're ruining my hit streak. Don't you guys care about the dick streak? That sounded really gross in a way I didn't mean it to. Sorry.
Anthony Rizzo.
Uh-oh. Top of the seventh, one out, bases loaded. Anthony Rizzo coming to the plate. Oh, please do not hit a grand slam.
Still hasn't shown up yet. Like you say, you got the bases loaded. You just wonder how many more of these opportunities are you going to get?
Come on, Tug Dick, get there, get there. Oh, no, he couldn't get there.
Get home the tying run.
That's not good. That's going to give them the lead. Oh, they were sending everybody there. They got the last runner, but they ended up scoring two runs before that. There's a bee in my room. Sorry. I see a bee or a wasp flying around. Some sort of creature. Awkward. Yeah, it's because they sent everybody. The worst part, though, is they got the lead now. We got to score a run. Top of the eighth, no outs.
Comes to the plate, and he'll start us off in the eighth.
Man, if only Tug Dick had played that a little better with his initial reaction. Would have. Oh no!
With a bang, as this is hit high and deep to left field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run.
Damn it, Cubbies!
A solo shot here to left. Sixth home run on the season for him. And with it, the Cubs have taken a 3-1.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. The guy who looks like his face got stung by a bee. See, I told you there was a bee in the house. Damn it, Ernest.
Well, maybe a big swing of the bat right there.
Ah, there's our multicolored pitcher right there, too.
Run here in the top of the eighth and make this a two-run ball game. That's going to allow his bullpen to pitch with a little more freedom out there.
Tug Dick tried, but he's just going to get up high enough. Tug Dick 0 for 3, bottom of the ninth. This is his last chance to keep the hit streak alive. Not to mention trying to have a chance to win. We're down by two runs.
Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one.
It looked like he was going to try to go the other way with that thing, but a wise idea there to try to hold up.
Checks his swing here, but he does so in
eager to try and hit it, but trying to be a little more patient. 2-0. If we're ever going to get a pitch, this is it.
The pitch.
Oh.
And that swung on and
a little higher than where I was looking. All right, 3-1.
And easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
If he would have swung at that, he would have never heard the end of it.
You think they'll give us something right down the middle?
And here's a
damn it. We did get something down the middle, but we just didn't get a good enough chunk of it. That sucks balls. Well, there goes the hit streak, and we lose. But for this episode, we were 1-2, because I forgot about... What are you yelling at, Bochy? Bochy, you're an ass. He had a 9-game hitting streak coming into this game. He has one bad game, and you're riding his ass. Oh, Tug Dick was getting up in his face. It's like, you want to go, old man? It's on like Donkey Kong. I'll see y'all next time. Thanks for hanging out, everybody.
Player of the game.
Yeah, not the longest outing he'll ever have. He only made it 6 full innings, but he definitely brought his good stuff to the ballpark, and he winds up helping his guys get out of here with victory.